I want to make a really bad long lizard joke, but I don't want to let it drag on. Talking of lizards, welcome to another brand new Trevor Henderson mod update. Today's update is the Behemoth. Dum, dum, dum. But first, if you enjoy videos like this and you want to see more, make sure you subscribe. It's free, and I'm yellow. So if we pull up the Trevor Henderson mod, we can see him, the Behemoth. According to the internet, he's a giant lizard-like creature the size of Mount Everest. But don't believe everything you read on the internet. First, we need to prove it. And we can do that by hitting that like button to make him appear. Have you done it? I don't think they were lying.
He's massive. He's got a million health. Did he come out of the earth? Okay, I think we're gonna need to see that again. Look at the size of this thing. His foot is bigger than the podium. Oh no. The lore is that his teeth are 8 kilometers long. I don't know if this guy is quite as big as Mount Everest. However, it seems like he's limited to Garry's mod. As you can see these lines, that's the size of this map. And he fills the whole thing. Oh boy. Let's spawn him in again and see how he comes out of the air. Oh my god, he just comes straight through me. All right, go a bit further back. Over there. Spawn in over there. Oh, he's just gonna go through me again. Okay. He's just too big. He's too big to see. I have an idea. If we're quick enough, we can prop resize him. Here we go. There it is. Oh, yeah. Oh, look at him. Oh, he does a little stretch. It's like my dog when she wakes up. Hello. Oh, he's kind of cute when he's this size. Why is he up here? Is he okay? Where are you going? Oh, he plonked. Now, we may need to concoct some of our experiments with the littler version just for the sake of physics. However, I'm going to spawn in the big lad again, and we'll see how his attacks fare. So I'm going to turn off disable thinking and spawn him in. Oh, there he comes. Out of the ground like a mountain. Apparently, he eats mountains, so maybe he's not going to be super interested in bananas. We'll see. Reminds me of Godzilla. Can I smack? Oh, I smacked him. Oh, I hit him right between the toes. Oh, that's such a bad place to get a paper cut. He's going to be furious. He doesn't care. He's leaving. Oh, he kind of looks like a dog, doesn't he? Am I crazy? Is he okay? What if I shoot him in the face? Or in the belly? Cake check. Did we decide that tails were cake? I don't remember. That's 10 out of 10 if so. So according to the wiki, instead of damaging players, he does what's called a fatality and can combo up to 50,000 damage. I think that might be enough to kill me. And when it reaches 750,000 health, it'll smash its hands on the ground and destroy structures and pretty much all the monsters near it. But first we're gonna need some monsters that can actually take him on. That's where Jerry comes in. Oh, Jerry, really? Really, Jerry? Jerry, you're gonna regret that when you meet my new friend. Also, make sure you stick around to the end of the video because he will be taking on the undefeated Sky Tentacles. It's a battle we've all wanted to see. So make sure you stick around. All right, Jerry, let's try this again. Ooh, Jerry's going for him. Oh, he's coming out of the ground and Jerry is doing no damage. It may appear like Jerry didn't really do anything because the Behemoth regens 2,500 health every half a second. That's Jerry's health in a second. So, Jerry, you're benched, lad. Before we try some other behemoths, I think we should call in the army. 4 tanks and 50 soldiers. Will they make a dent? Let's find out. Good luck, lads. Oh, please don't shoot me. Ooh, is the behemoth furious? Do they care? You all right, lad? He's behind you. Area secure. Turn around. What do you mean? Oh, they've spotted him. Well, this guy has. Everyone else thinks the area's clear. What the? Really? Oh, something's happening. That tank's going for something. Ooh. Oh, the war has begun, lads. I don't think I hired the smartest army. Whoa. What the? Is he aiming for me? Guys, chill. What the heck's going on? Maybe if I stand in front of him. Oh, no. Oh, no. There comes the bullets again. No. Oh. Did they get him? Hey, they did a damage. Look at his health. They did it. Good stuff. Oh, look at those bullet holes. That did one. Okay. Well, the army failed miserably. But before we spawn in some other behemoths to see how strong they are in comparison, I'm going to crawl inside his mouth. Oh, is there room for me in there? I feel like there probably is. And we're in. It reminds me of that scene in Nemo. Do you remember? Look how tiny I am. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Get me out of here. Oh, I feel like a fly. Am I a fly? Look at his eyeball. Banana. For scale, and I'm a human-sized banana. We can even go inside of his tongue, see the back of his throat, and pass all the way through him. Pretty spacious in here. Oh my god. What? So according to the wiki, he is related to a lot of the other behemoths. So let's see if you'll fight them. Starting with the bird watcher, who in comparison looks really little. Good luck, lads. Is he mad? Does he mind? Ooh.
Oh, the bird watcher doesn't like him. So I've been trying all morning to convince this behemoth to fight anything. And for some reason, he is either a pacifist, which I don't think he is, or he's just too big to figure out what he's supposed to do. For example, let's set 5 living buildings on him and a million kids. What does he think about it? He doesn't mind. He's not an arachnophobe. And they, as you can see, they are actually doing damage to him. It's little. He's pretty good damage reduction, but they are doing stuff. Which leads me to my next option, which is just to simply get inside. And I can, I believe, roar? Ah! I've just killed practically all of them with that roar. And now I can start stamping on them. Unfortunately, we can't really see what's... Oh, can we see in the shadow? Giving them a little... Give him a little swoop and then hit him with the munch. So if I right click, I can execute them. And there we go. Easy. Just like that. Gone. The roar. Unfortunately, I don't know why the sound effect isn't working. Can we add a sound effect for the roar? Here it comes. Beautiful. And that roar is the attack that practically kills everything. And he'll do that when he reaches 750,000 health. But currently, you can only climb up inside him to get him to do it. But I'm sure it'll be fixed soon. Now, we can also test this roar on this tiny little destructible building I've got here. And see if he'll huff and he'll puff and blow it all down. Let's get close to it. And roar. Oh, it's very laggy. He did it. Oh my god. He turned it to splinters. So the roar is, it does work. It definitely does work. And of course, we can't not break his bones. Is that how he walks? It's not very elegant. I honestly have no idea how this is gonna go, but let's just break some of his bones. Is he okay? Oh, that looks painful. He's a little wonky. He's sort of fixed himself, though. He's looking... Oh, no. You know, you see those dogs on Instagram that have the tongues out permanently? Reminds me of that. He's also scooting his booty when the peanut butter gets stuck to the roof of your mouth.
Get it off.
Oh, no. Oh, no. We've turned him into a turkey. Oh, he just gets derpier and derpier. He's kind of adorable. He may be the cutest monster yet. Let me know in the comments who you think is the cutest. I'd have to say I'd usually vote for one of these two. Definitely not this guy.
What?
I wonder what an army of Jerrys can do to little derpy dino over there. Oh, they found his hitbox. Apparently, it's a mile from him. Half the Jerrys are just resting. They're yet to do a single point of damage. He is so beefy. Now I'm simply going to try and figure out a way with my Jerry army to just take him down. Maybe this'll do it. This gun seems a little nuts. All right. I think I'm on fire. Chickens? Golden chickens. No? Banana? What about some Saitama fists? Ooh. Oh, okay. Now we're talking. Even one punch man can't kill this guy in one punch. Look at my lovely little hands. Okay. He's at 50,000 health. Did I say 50,000? Half a million. 340,000. 250,000. 170. Oh, he's close. Is this going to do it? 14,000. Can the Jerrys do it? Jerrys, you're not doing anything. Jerrys. Jerrys, we killed him. I was trying to kill you. You bunch of dumb idiots. Come here, you. All right, we need a fresh one. Get him in the mouth, lads. Are we doing it? Come here, you. Got him. You next, lad. What about you? Where you go? Where do you think you're going, Jerrys? Not today, baby. I don't know. I don't know why I'm still doing this. So I'm now going to possess him and take on an army of 50 Jerrys. As you can see, they're down there. Those are Jerrys. They're not ants. They're actual Jerrys. And I'm going to perform my roar. And just like that, all the Jerrys... Oh, no.
Oh, the Jerrys.
What if we turn him into a banana? Oh, Dad? So I did promise you a fight between Sky Tentacles and the Behemoth. However, I cannot guarantee they'll actually just start fighting. Let's drag over Sky Tentacles and see if he's interested. Oh, he seems a little furious. Oh, it seems like the Behemoth's... He's rising to the challenge again. Where's he going? Is he okay? Is he stood on him? Sky Tentacles has spawned in some beams. He knows he's there. Get down. Oh, he's fallen. Is he going for him? What the... Are you okay? What's happening? Is he an alligator now? Ooh, he's doing a thing. He's headbutting him. They are fighting. Neither of them are doing damage, I don't think. Sky Tentacles, I think he took some damage. He's taking damage. He's taken about 5,000 so far. Ladies and gentlemen, you're witnessing here for a world first. He's fighting. He stopped. He's given up. He's had enough. Okay. Fair enough. Sky Tentacles has done one damage to him. I'm climbing in Sky Tentacles. I'm giving him the biscuits. Ooh, We killed him. How did we do that? I right-clicked. I think that's his execute. That seems a little overpowered. And the only way to really make it a fair test is to climb inside the behemoth and try and execute sky tentacles. And just like that, we've done it. So I'm gonna have to call this one a tie. Until we can truly see them fight, everyone's a winner. It's been a rough day for the banana at his testing facility. I'm looking a little worse for wear. But if you've enjoyed this video and you'd like to see me make him fight Godzilla, smack that like button. Also remember to subscribe. It's free, and I'm yellow.